Hello, everyone, and welcome to Today We Play. My name is Marty Sleven. I am honored to be joined by Jamate. Jamate, how are you?
Hello. I can see on the stream that I'm behind a Discord volume.
You're gone
so
now.
I'm currently hidden. But hello,
fixed
guys.
It. No, I fixed it. You're fine.
Nice.
Welcome, everyone. Welcome to Today We Play for Friday, December 16th. We decided today that we wanted to do something a little festive in the spirit of the holidays. And so we are going to be playing my favorite Christmas level of all time from one of my favorite games of all time, Banjo-Kazooie. And before we get started, I just want everyone, I'm the first time I'm doing an official escapist stream with two of us plus game. So I'm going to have to be doing stuff with the audios live. So I just want everyone, how do I sound and how does Jamate sound?
Hello, this is an example of me saying words so you guys can hear my volume. How about that?
Look at that, we did it. And we'll go into the game. And if the game starts screaming, I apologize. So, Mousecatcher said I sound quiet. I can go up. You can go up.
Yeah, sure.
Let me know if Jay sounds quiet. Let me know if I need to lower the game
volume. We got multiple saying we're both fine, which is good.
Damn. I thought that
how's
was
the game volume, guys, in comparison?
Now that we got Banjo on the screen running through the little desert.
Game's a bit too loud, apparently.
Game's a bit too loud. We can fix that. You know what? We learned how to fix that.
We've got the forbidden knowledge.
We do. How does this
DJ in chat says, "Hello, escapist. I've been watching you for years. Goodbye." DJ, why are you leaving? Why are you doing your drive-by hello? Why don't you stay for a
maybe
bit?
Maybe DJ was deeply offended by Banjo-Kazooie. Which is
possible. Fair.
A lot of people have been deeply offended by Banjo-Kazooie before.
Yeah, for years.
So
better.
Game volume good, chat?
Yeah, it says better, so I think we're all good. We can adjust those things as we go, but I think so far we're doing good.
Absolutely. Jay, what's your do you have any history with Banjo-Kazooie?
I have a weird history with Banjo-Kazooie. So I played a lot of Nintendo 64 when I was a kid. It was my console and I loved it. Well, it wasn't my console, it was my dad's console, and I used to go visit him, and I used to play all of his games, and Banjo-Kazooie was one of the games that I for some reason horrifically struggled with.
Oh, really?
I don't know if it was my age. I think mostly it's because I'm dumb, but I just struggled a lot with it. So I haven't got that far into it, but okay. I have fond memories of the early levels. Okay. Do you know one of those games from your childhood where just replayed the same thing over and over?
Yeah, and I wasn't good enough to get very far in it, and so I just sort of replayed certain levels, like ad nauseum, and I was like, this is good, I'm having fun.
Yeah.
It's one of my favorite games of all time. I did a full stream recently on my channel. It's one of those games that hit at the right time. I had a weird history with it because it came out right around my birthday. And it was a summer, so my mom's from Poland, and that summer we were visiting all my family in Poland. And so I got the game for my birthday, as well as the strategy guide, but we went to Poland the next day for like a month and a half, and I didn't bring the Nintendo 64, but I brought the strategy guide, and like, via osmosis, would play the game. Routes through the strategy guide.
That's like the crate. So it's everyone's done this, right? I say everyone, maybe the younger generation haven't done this, but when you used to buy games back in the day, your parents would like drive you home and you would read the strategy, not the strategy guide, but like the manual booklet. and strategy guide. And you, like you say, supplementary, like play the game via that.
Yeah.
You had that on crack a month and a half reading a strategy.
For like a month and a half. Yeah.
Did you like breeze through the game when you finally got it then?
I think I ended up becoming incredible at the game, and like I just did. Like when I streamed through, in 10 hours I have a perfect save file. I found everything, and even like last night I wanted to get to the Christmas level in this game because it's like the fifth level, and so I would want to play through the first couple levels. And it was just muscle memory, and I'm like, it's really weird that like. I've forgotten incredibly important things over the years, and yet I still know the insides and outs of this dumb witch's cavern.
Well, to be honest, if you let anyone... Because how old were you? Were you quite young?
I was 11, probably.
So an 11-year-old kid who's on holiday for a month and a half.
Yeah.
with the strategy guide, you are going to absorb every single word.
Especially
of that
in
thing.
Like Poland, it was like very rural Poland, so this was like farmland Poland, like wow. You know, still using an outhouse Poland. So,
oh my god,
you know what? Great Banjo-Kazooie strategy guide, great outhouse reading. One thing I want to do with the stream too, because you and I, we've been doing Friday streams for a couple months, and we were talking about how we didn't really have like a theme. We did some Kami, we did some Earthbound, we did Guild Wars, we did Willow Week. But one of the themes we kind of started off with was the idea of something called Show and Tell. And it was kind of like us being able to just be like, oh, well, we can, you know, show off something like we really like to another person who does, who might not be super familiar with it. And we kind of had that a little bit, like not with Okami, because we're both really familiar with Okami.
Yeah, we love like Okami, yeah.
A little bit with Earthbound, and then Guild Wars. And so I was like, this is sort of in this spirit of that. So I wanted to show you some stuff from this game I really love, and why I love the game, and then get into the Freeze Easy Peak thing. One thing I love about this game, I don't know if this is a thing you ever knew. So the game has one core musical theme song. That's the reason I keep hanging out in this area. So in the witch's lair, she has this one core theme song. You're not watching live, so you're not able to see it. But there's this one core theme song, and the closer you get to a themed level, the music just morphs into, it's the same tune, but in the guise of whatever level you are. So the core castle music, when I approach this pirate level, gets a like pirate fiddle and like sea shanty vibe to it. And
that's really cool.
Yeah, and when you approach like the haunted mansion, it gets like a spooky vibe to it without like, it's not adjusting and changing tracks or anything. It's just like the music is like morphing in real time, which is like something that's like really
that's really cool.
Yeah.
I made a very similar system for one of my final projects when I was studying at university. I made a dynamic music system where it was a village.
Okay.
And each part, so there was one musical track for the village. And then depending on whether you were in combat or what part of the village you were in, the musical instruments in the song would change. So the drum track wasn't there unless you were in combat. And when you went down onto the beach, there'd be, the melody would be played by a harp. Because it's, you know, very siren.
I love that.
And the church bell, there was a church and it had a bell, and it would play the music when you got close to the church and stuff like that. So I've dabbled in stuff like that before. It's not crazy easy to set up.
I was gonna say, I imagine there's like a kind of dynamism to it that's tough to nail, but if you do it, I don't know, it gives like a real sense of like life and energy to a setting, and almost makes it feel like you have a full orchestra and composer behind you that's interacting with what you're doing.
Yeah. It feels good. It feels great. Just a lot of work. So I've never played this level.
Okay, you've never played the Christmas level. So level 5, Freeze Easy Peak. In games you have played, do you think there's like do you have standout Christmas levels? In chat, I'm curious to hear too. Like, are there like winter levels, Christmas levels that like stick out in games? There's not a ton, but like, in the same way people will watch, you know, Home Alone and Elf and Miracle on 34th Street, and, you know, Peanuts Christmas Special. Like, are there game things that that anyone sort of you know, revisits every year?
I'm intrigued to hear chats, because mine, the only ones that come to mind, because I'm finding it hard to even think of themed. Maybe snow-themed ones, but not Christmas ones. Like, the ones that come to mind are Mario 64.
Yeah,
and
Fat Highlander just mentioned that.
Yeah. And that's... They come to mind pretty quick. The Mario Odyssey one. Yeah, Mario Odyssey is really good. With the racing, with the Fat Yeti people, that's great.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, those guys are cute. A lot of MMOs, I guess, and not MMOs, but, like, persistent games will do, like, events around the holidays.
Events, yeah. Guild Wars does an event, so does World of Warcraft. And, yeah, like, a lot of MMOs.
Yeah. I know Fortnite always does, like, winter events and everything. So right off the bat, in a Christmas level, in the spirit of Christmas, the first thing we do is enter this igloo, and there's these four polar bears who are upset because... Or three polar bears... Because well, this is me just projecting, but I assume their mother is dead, was killed. I don't know what kills polar bears, like on the food chain, like what's above polar bear.
Natural causes.
Oh, okay, like global warming, man.
Yeah, I somebody said to me, is like, it's the difference between brown and black bears. It's like, if it's brown, get down. If it's black, it's like, run. But if you see a polar bear, you're dead.
Yeah.
Because they will get you.
If you see a polar bear, so like, just come to terms with your god. Yeah.
Yeah, so I don't think that polar bears have natural predators. The cold bite of winter. I guess if they got like bear pattern baldness and they just froze to death.
Bear pattern baldness. so yeah, we're in this igloo. There's these three children. They're crying because their father has left them on Christmas and they don't have any presents. And then we go down the hill and their dad is just fucking drunk and passed out at the bottom of the hill. My stomach aches. I shouldn't have eaten that shiny thing. Someone help poor old Boggy. This is truly one of history's worst fathers.
Yeah, this guy needs his children taken away, honestly.
I think so a regular ground pound on his stomach won't work. We need to like really, we need to find a way in the level to like really, really, really fuck up his stomach. In the spirit of Christmas. Really fucking up someone's stomach.
Yeah, Mousecatcher, you've just reminded me, it's brown get down, black fight back, polar bear be aware, you're dead.
White bear, you're dead.
Yeah. Chris S, member for 5 months, says, I bloody love this game. Says, much better than Mario 64.
Agreed, Chris S.
Ooh.
I might be the only human being on Earth that agrees, but agree, Chris S.
I need to play this because I absolutely love Mario 64. I love platforming.
I think maybe the only reason I feel that way is because of my sojourn in Poland.
Yeah, definitely. I think if you read a Mario 64 strategy guide,
everything would have been different. My whole life would have been different.
Yeah, completely. Yeah, you'd be in a completely different position.
So this challenge now, there's a Christmas tree, and we have to light it up using these little anthropomorphic lights. However, there's these little gremlins. I'm not exactly sure what they're called. I'm just calling them gremlins. They're like little
No, they're little, definitely gremlins.
Yeah, little gremlins. And they pop up every once in a while trying to eat them. So you gotta kind of do a timed whack-a-mole. Have you ever done a timed whack-a-mole?
I'm gonna be real. I think most whack-a-moles are timed because you have to time your hits.
Could you imagine how exhausting it would be if they weren't timed, if it was just an eternal whack-a-mole?
Eternal whack-a-mole. I think that's hell.
Is that a hell punishment? One of the circles of Dante's Inferno?
I think so. I think it's like the seventh level of hell.
Yeah.
Even before somebody in chat knows the seventh level of hell. I know what my hell would be, like, and I've known this for a long time.
Okay.
Hell for me would be me sat on a couch, putting in my username and password on a remote control.
Oh my god.
On a TV.
My YouTube on my Xbox so often will do that. It'll be like,
I forgot
email address, buddy. And I'm like, why? Crunchyroll does the same thing. I'm like, Crunchyroll, I just want my Mob Psycho. Why are you doing this to me? I just want my Japanese animation.
It actually hurts my soul. And I get really frustrated when I have to do it. And I often spell things wrong because I'm dumb and dyslexic. And usually people are with me when I'm trying to do it. So I'm under pressure.
And then it's just getting worse.
And I get frustrated and they're like, hey, chill, Jay. It's fine. Just put the password in right. And I'm like, you don't understand. I'm enraged right now.
You need to like find a stat. Be like, no. It happens to like a lot of people. Like 90% of people between the ages of 25 and 55 have it happen to them once in their life.
Yeah.
So to make up for the deadbeat dad, we have found one present so far. We need to find three presents to bring them back to the orphaned children. I guess they're not orphaned because they have a deadbeat dad. And I guess I don't know that their mom's dead. I'm just making an assumption. The game never like straight up says
your headcanon is the mom is dead.
Maybe that was like lore inside the player's guide. Like inside the strategy guide was like, oh, these are three bears named Wimpy, Dimpy, and Stimpy. Their mom died.
Their mom's dead.
Their mom died.
That's my favorite page.
Their mom died because of the Exxon Valdez.
Yeah. Turn to page 7 for dead mom.
Just press X to pay your specs. It's fine.
Exactly.
What's going on here? This thing's not... Okay. There's a frozen jiggy. The collectible in this game, they're jiggies. Each stage has 10 jiggies. Those are like the equivalent of stars, the little jigsaw pieces.
Yeah, the little jigsaw pieces, yeah.
It was weird because this was around the time Getting Jiggy With It became big, the Will Smith song. So it feels Yeah, it feels like Jiggy was in the air. The summer of
I think.
Jiggy.
maybe Will Smith was just a huge Banjo-Kazooie fan. Maybe he also had a Poland exchange strategy guide.
After
situation.
Filming Men in Black 1, he decided to spend a month and a half in Poland. It was like, oh, damn, yeah, yeah. I don't have my N64, but I have my...
He's like, I need to reconnect. I'm really getting away from my music roots. I'm gonna go read the Banjo-Kazooie strategy guide in Poland for a month.
That's a rare thing, the whole Banjo-Kazooie in Poland thing, the strategy guide thing. That might be one of those rare instances where I'm almost positive I'm the only person in human history who has that exact experience.
Yeah, like, no one else has.
Yeah,
that.
Most things are like, oh yeah, I can relate with that. Like, that is just a very strange, like, oh, what the hell's going on with that guy?
The closest I could get was just that feeling we've all had of driving home reading a manual.
Sure, yeah. That one, like, everyone, I feel like everyone can empathize with. But
I've got a little bit closer. Okay. I used to take...
Is it here?
Wait there, I might actually have it.
Show and tell. Why is this not working? I feel like I'm absolutely going through this tree. No, whatever. I have to do dive bombs on the snowman's head. And let me tell you guys, not easy.
Okay. I have it here. This is the Oblivion.
Hell yeah.
The Oblivion manual.
Okay.
That I've had for absolutely donkey's years. I used to take this. I used to take this with me to
on
places where I couldn't play the game.
Oh.
And I think once I even took it to school. I think.
Did you ever take it away from you? Was the teacher like, you can't have this?
No, game. I took it to, like, because I... So I was like a bit of a secret nerd as a kid. Like,
I'm gonna be honest, I was carrying around that Oblivion manual. I don't feel like that's a good way to keep a secret.
But so like Guild Wars, I used to like, when I was a kid, I used to hang out, like a teenager, I used to hang out with the big quotation marks here, the popular kids.
Ooh,
you know, that kind of
trick. Yeah, yeah.
But like deep in my heart, I was this like sweaty nerd who just wanted to play games. So all of my friends would be like, oh, like we want to like go to the park and like after school and like go drink and do drugs and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And I'd be like, I just want to go home and play Guild Wars.
I love it.
So I'd like make excuses to go home, like go play games. But then I kind of got out of that, like I was like, I don't care what people think. And I just would like stuck to my true self. But I used to take this places where I couldn't like play games when
I
really play Oblivion a lot and read it in secret and be like, I'm going to figure out, because I used to get stuck in games quite a lot as a kid. And, do you have to like knock into all of those buttons to get...
Yeah,
massive jiggy.
Yeah, so that's there's just 10 jiggies. There's all sorts of jiggy tasks. You know about jiggy tasks, don't you?
I know all about jiggy tasks,
yeah.
And you know that for a fact.
It was kind of rude to me to even assume you didn't know about jiggy tasks.
Yeah. I feel offended that you you even thought that I might not. Snake in the Garden gives €2 and says, "Mom is watching with me today, so behave, boys."
Oh, hello, Snake in the Garden's mom.
What's up, Snake of the Gardens mom? How are you doing? By the way, we're always on our best behavior.
Yeah, see, Jay didn't do drugs. He went to play
games. Yeah, I didn't.
Yeah, he went
to
go play games.
I chose to play games instead, which is just a different form of drug.
And, which has its own problems, but it's fine.
Oh, 100%. I was having this conversation with someone the other day. Like, I know people who are very heavily addicted to weed.
Right.
Okay. And I was having a conversation with them about like addiction. And then I was like, oh yeah, I'm not really addicted to anything. And they were like, well, you're addicted to games.
Yeah.
And I was like, nah, I'm not. And they're like,
it's just my job.
Could you, yeah, like, could I take away all of your consoles and your PC away from you for a week? And I said, no, I'd kill you.
I mean, because of work or like because you need to play the games?
No, because I just need to play.
Oh.
I get itchy. I need to.
You can't itch.
Like if I've been editing for if I've been editing for too long about games, but it's not games. I'm just like, I need to play something. I need to scratch that itch specifically here.
Now I'm gonna feel bad anytime we do a stream together. I'm like, am I enabling? Is this bad? Am I doing bad? Are we the baddies?
Yeah, 100%. Yeah, I'm getting secondhand game high right now.
Secondhand banjo high. You're experiencing those Polish
I am.
Polish vibes. Okay, I gotta catch this little Jinjo's hanging out on a broom. Don't you hate it when a little Jinjo's on a broom?
All the time. I say that every time I wake up.
If I had a nickel for every time a Jinjo was hanging out on a broom. I saw someone say earlier about Christmas levels, and they said, I don't really like them because usually they're ice levels. And ice levels are notoriously sort of a pain in the ass, right? Like, my movement is slippery. Like, whether it's a Zelda dungeon that's ice or a Mario level that's ice, anything where you can't stop on a dime and your momentum continues. I don't mind. If used sparingly, I don't mind them. In the grand pantheon themed levels.
It's like underwater levels. If they're done correctly, I think you don't really notice them.
And I guess that's everything in games, right? Like, if done well, there's like no hard and fast rule of like an escort mission can be done well. Maybe.
Yeah, for sure. 100%. I missed, because of the donation, I missed old Hunter's message to me. It says, good design Delve episode on Souls-likes. Is that going to replace Anatomy? Or are those going to be two different things? Yeah, so thank you very much, first of all. Second, if anybody doesn't know already, so what came out for Early Access members today, a few hours ago, was my first episode of a kind of new show called Design Delve, which is going to be replacing Anatomy, but don't fret, because not much is changing. It's basically the same show, but because of the name change and the rebranding, it allows me to cover broader topics. Mm-hmm. So the first one's on why most Souls-likes fail and the designs of why that is. And with Anatomy, I wouldn't have been able to cover that because of the name. It would have to be on a game, the Anatomy of something. So we've changed it. So yes, it is going to be replacing Anatomy, but it's functionally the same thing.
Yeah, it's more of it sort of opens you up to be able to explore, like you said, broader topics, as opposed to this week I need to do the Final Fantasy VII episode, and this week I need to do the Banjo episode. Like, you can explore, instead of just saying one Souls-like game, sort of a fundamental design thing in all of From Software's Souls-likes.
Yeah. And I can do both. I can still cover individual games, which is the beauty of the redesign and why
it makes it more
I've been thinking about doing it for a while.
Yeah,
100%.
So, we went down the slide. We landed on the bad dad, and he vomited his Jiggy. But instead of going home to be with his children on Banjo Christmas, he has race fever. And he's like, we need to go onto our sleds, and I need to race you. So it's like a dad who's got like a gambling addiction, and it's like, what are you doing? Go, your children.
Race fever.
Yeah,
this is ridiculous.
Your children, who may or may not have lost their mother. Oh no, he won't race me because he will only race a walrus. I think.
Not only is he a gambler, he's also a racist.
Yeah, waiting for someone to race me. We'll race you, numbskull. Sorry, you're too big for my sled. I can only race someone smaller. So we need to find Mumbo Jumbo, who's our slightly culturally inappropriate shaman who exists across some of the levels. We need to have him transform us into a walrus. Or what's a small walrus called? Not a smallrus, but like is there a mollusk?
A smallrus?
A mollusk?
Is a mollusk?
A what's a mollusk?
My dog just busted into the room. I'm working, doggy.
Does this guy not know what a small walrus is?
Ludo, do you know what a small walrus is? You're an animal. Come here.
Ludo.
Say hello to everyone.
Oh, look at Ludo.
Look at a puppy.
Look at Ludo.
Not a puppy for much longer.
Have you guys gotten snow yet? And does Ludo like
this? Yeah. So we haven't had snow where I live.
Okay.
For years. And
for
one
years.
Day I woke
those
up
parts
and
of
it was.
That haven't had snow for years.
Yeah, down where I was.
No, I don't know.
And basically, are you staying in or are you going out? I think she's staying in. And I hadn't had it for years, and then one day just woke up and it was snowing. So I took the little puppy out. Like even today when I took it for a walk, so where I live, it's like, I live in rural England. So I live in the countryside.
Okay.
So everywhere around me is just like fields and open land, and everything was just ice.
Oh no.
And it was my dog's first experience of just like icy grass and just like floor. And like every puddle that was frozen over, like Ludo was like,
what is like, this? I don't
really
like it.
Freaked out. Yeah, it really freaked out. But yeah, she's experienced it. We don't get a lot of snow. I really like snow. We get it so infrequently that it's like an event when it happens. Mm. Like England, if we get like proper snow, England's very famous for just shutting down because we can't handle it.
I can appreciate that.
Like our infrastructure isn't built for it.
Well, you definitely get some snow because I remember in the hit film Harry Potter, Ron says, "Happy Christmas, Harry."
Yeah, he did, and he can legally you can only say that in England if it's snowing.
But Hogwarts is weird because they can just make the snow with their weird little wands.
Yeah, it's weird with their little sticks, right?
Yeah, with their little magic sticks.
Kind of cringe, if you ask me.
someone in chat said that the mom. Oh, Kitchen Link says the kid's mom shows up in the sequel, and if that's true, incredible. I don't know Banjo-Tooie very well. I'm planning on streaming it soon, but the kid's
you
mom
better
shows
read
up.
That strategy guide. What are you doing?
I need to go on eBay. I need to go back to Poland for a month and a half. Nick, I gotta go back to Poland for a month and a half to relive my youth.
Business expense the ticket.
I gotta go find an Airbnb with an outhouse to
relive. Oh, I missed the donation from B-Pen for $5. Thank you very much.
Hey, B-Pen.
It says Double D's getting new life with a new daddy. That sentence hurt to read. Thanks, B-Pen.
I
appreciate it.
I love that sentence. I thought that seemed sentence.
I know you would. Yeah. You didn't read it. If you read it out, I think you'd have a completely different experience.
In front of Snake and the Guard's mom, of all people.
I know, right?
Okay, so I found the three presents. I've come back to their home because their degenerate father obviously won't be there. Wow, dead thank beat. You, Brown Bear. Oh, I didn't realize we're all bears. I didn't really put that together. I'm a brown bear. God. They're little white bears. They got something for me. What is it? Solid gold jiggy. Thank you, children. I love you all.
Nice.
Merry Christmas to you, children.
Well, you're going to have to. You're going to have to adopt them.
Oh, no. This is like a dysfunctional relationship, though. Banjo-Kazooie. We don't know what's going on with them. We don't know if they're like friends, lovers, both. Friendly lovers.
Friends with benefits?
Ooh, friends with banjo fits?
I was just about to say that. Fuck you.
Yeah, your brain's not as broken.
Oh, sorry, Mouse Catcher's mom.
You
not Mouse Catcher's mom, Snake of the Guard. I know, Snake of the Guard's mom. I'm so sorry. Actually, Snake of the Guard's mom might be one of those cool moms that is fine with swearing. I don't know.
She's probably Irish, and they do a lot of cusses. I watch Banshees of Inisherin. They do all sorts of cusses. Instead of saying fucking, they say feckin'. Do you know that? Feckin'
oh,
with an
E.
Even in the subtitles,
wish,
it shows up with an E.
Really?
Yeah.
I wish Darren was here.
It's incredible. I watched Banshees of Inisherin, which is the new Martin McDonagh, Colin Farrell, Brendan Gleeson film. That's the director who did In Bruges.
Is
and
that
Billboards.
The one where he like decides to just not like this guy anymore?
Yeah, yeah. These two friends.
Yeah,
on
I
little,
saw the trailer for that because I love the director
of
work.
Ireland during the Irish Civil War. And one day, one dude's just like, I just don't want to be friends with you anymore, just because I don't like you anymore. It's about how like the other guy just can't handle it. Cause the other guy's like really nice, but it's just like how the two of them can't handle it. Saw it in theaters. It is just deeply Irish, like in terms of like it is hard to understand. Saw it again. It's on HBO Max now with subtitles. Even better. I can now understand everything. And yes, they say feckin'.
Now it's got subs. Oh yeah. God. I would love to watch that. The director's work, like his short films and like In Bruges, absolutely
so good.
Fantastic
yeah.
movie.
Yeah, and it's repairing the two of them from In Bruges.
Beautiful.
Yeah. Older, wiser. So yeah, I'm a little... Oh, and everyone in chat, apparently a mollusk is like a clam. What's the name for a little like a sea lion? Am I thinking of sea lions?
A sea lion is a different creature.
It's a whole different
I believe.
Thing.
It's a whole what different... is a baby walrus? I'm googling it. A calf. It's called a calf.
Calf? Like a cow?
Yeah, like a cow. A baby walrus is called a calf.
I don't think things should be able to share names. I think everything should have to have a different name. Oh no, I have to race this dude now. Great. All you need to do is steer your sled through the red slalom gates and beat me in the end. Got it? 3, 2,
please
one,
beat him.
Go. Okay, this is, I'm going to be honest. This gave me trouble, not only as a child, but as a fully grown adult. So we're going to see how this race goes. He cheats a little bit. He takes hard corners. He bullies me out of the way. He plays bully ball.
It just sounds like a terrible person.
He's like a bear. Yeah, he's a real bad dude. In the grand scheme of bears, look at he's just being rude.
One thing I'm kind of impressed with this that I never noticed as a kid, is the camera in this game.
So if you played on an N64, camera not as good. This is the Xbox Live Arcade port from the 360 era, which added a second stick camera and everything, like Rare. Because by that point, Rare became a first-party Microsoft studio. And so they didn't change anything in the game, but they made the camera better. They HD-ified it and everything. So this is a much more playable version of the game than probably what you remember.
Yeah, for sure.
Oh, crunched him. I crunched him right at the finish line. Crunched him in a good way. Not like crunched him.
Get wrecked, dude. Snake in the Garden gives €2, thank you very much, and says, Mum's review, they seem like nice and genuine boys. Stay for the remainder of the stream and see if that opinion stays.
Or go out on top. I don't know if Snake in the Garden's mom's talking about us or Banjo and Kazooie. Also, great boys. Although I'm not sure, I always thought Kazooie was a girl.
I agree. I was just about to say that. What's the gender of that bird?
Yeah, I would say Google it, but it's probably gonna take you to some sites you don't want to go to.
Kazooie a girl?
Make sure safe search is on.
A male bear named Banjo and his friend, a large female red bird named Kazooie.
Okay.
Okay. Specifically large.
Specifically large. She's pretty big. Yeah, she's able to.
It's a huge ass bird.
She's able to carry Banjo on her legs. This game, the 360 port, also. So the N64 game had this really kind of like impressive for the time technology that they didn't actually follow through for mostly. It was called Stop and Swap. And their whole idea was that they wanted to link Banjo-Kazooie and Banjo-Tooie for the N64 using this method called Stop and Swap, where you would do something in Banjo-Kazooie and the game, it would be like a secret, and the game would store the memory on whatever modicum of internal memory the N64 had. And you would then take the cartridge out and put Banjo-Tooie in. And if you did it quick enough, the N64 would be able to send the memory back that you stored on the N64 to the new game. And thus be like, oh, we know what you did in the previous game, so now you can unlock this new thing. And I think Rare wanted to do it. Nintendo was like, we don't want you doing a thing where people are ejecting cartridges with their consoles on and it could possibly like brick a game or that kind of thing, so they pretty much
teaching kids to do that.
So they pretty much scrapped it and then added a bunch of those functionalities in with when it came to the 360, because you obviously didn't have to be stopping or swapping.
I'm glad they did do that, because it just sounds like a bad idea. There's so many problems I can see with that, like, arising.
Yeah, Mousecatcher is saying it sounds a little bit like Sonic & Knuckles. Sonic & Knuckles did a similar thing, but they had, like, the... Do you remember what the Knuckles cartridge from Sonic & Knuckles looked like?
Wasn't it, like, a cartridge that goes on top of another cartridge?
Yeah, it was a little... Actually, I have it. I showed it to Yahtzee on a stream.
You've got it? I'm so excited.
I got it somewhere. Let me see.
I've got something less exciting for stream. I got some party rings. Let's go.
Okay. So yeah, Sonic & Knuckles was a Sega Genesis game that had this weird little flap. And you would open the flap, and then you could put a game on top of it, and then you would put it all in the Sega Genesis. And so if you put Sonic 3 on top of it, it would give you almost like the director's cut of Sonic 3. but then if you put other games on it, you might get other things on it. It's very strange. I don't know.
What things happen?
You get little bonus games, like you would unlock. You'd just be able to play different versions of like the Sonic 3 bonus game. Yeah, one, it would just steal your credit card. That one probably.
Fuck yeah. But...
Mouse catcher says, yeah. Go ahead.
What a buttering. That's a buttering.
What is that, like a Funyun?
Nah, it's like a biscuit, or you would, I don't know, you'd call them cookies.
Oh, okay. We got those little guys. I don't know. They're not called buttering.
Yeah, they're called buttering. It was recently my birthday, so.
You know what? Happy birthday! And I'm glad. Did you get a box of P rings?
I did. I got two box P rings.
That's a lot of P rings.
It's a shit ton of P-rings.
In this economy? Are you kidding me?
Yeah, now I'm going to eat them.
Now I'm going to eat them. I'm trying to see. We're doing well in this level. We got 94 of the jiggies. No, 94 of the notes. 94 out of 100. And 7 of the jiggies. No, we're not just going to stop playing when I finish this level. We're going to go up to 2 hours. We'll play some more levels.
Talking about, like, things that I got for my birthday. Yeah. One of them was this Jamate sign, which I think is backwards currently. On the stream?
No, it's forwards on the stream. Yeah,
you can see that. Which is really cool, but it suddenly just got a lot brighter.
Uh-oh.
And I don't understand why, and I think I'm about to blow up.
Maybe, like, the more you embrace your inner Jamate, the brighter it gets. It's almost like... Also... It's like, what's it called? What was that shitty shield called? Or the sword? Sting.
Sting. Shitty sword. Sting.
I like... That's like a top 5 sword, right? Like
that is top 5 sword. Yeah. I name a sword. What is
sword.
The number?
Master sword.
Master sword. Excalibur.
Excalibur, that's a big one. Yeah.
Sting.
Sting.
Glamdring.
Yeah. Masamune from Chrono Trigger plus Japanese mythology plus a lot of other things.
Narsil,
that's a good one. Soul Reaver's a cool sword.
Alright, that's stuck. I've got Orcris here.
Whose sword is that?
This is the sword. Fucking hell. I can't even remember his name. Main hobbit. Not the main hobbit. Main dwarf from The Hobbit.
What is the main dwarf's name?
I can't remember. Gringor. This is his sword. It's called Orcris.
What is that? What is that shitty dwarf's name? Pringles? Is his name Pringles?
Thorin. Thorin Oakenshield.
Thorin Oakenshield. I knew that.
I've got Orcris. Also, not a sword, but another thing I got for my birthday.
Fucking gun, mate. Does anybody like the hit? Well, not really a hit TV show. Flop TV show, but now a cult classic, Firefly.
Oh, is that Mal's gun?
It's Mal's gun from Firefly.
The Mal gun.
The Mal gun.
I love Firefly.
Yeah, I said to my... he was like, I offhandedly mentioned that I really like Mal's gun from Firefly. And then for my birthday, he just made it for me because that's his job. He makes 3D models. So it is way bigger than I thought it was.
Mal's a lot stronger than I thought.
Yeah, like it's a beefy gun. I think maybe I'm just tiny. Like I'm.
That should be
I'm
a new
itty-bitty.
Series: Beefy Gun or Tiny Boy. that's really cool.
Yeah.
Also, a lot of people are naming fictional swords that they like, and a lot of them sound fake to me. I mean, they're fictional swords.
Dagger of Time. Yeah, that's really cool. This Prince of Persia series
is
just great.
That one's real. And that one's cool. Oh, son of a.
Stormbringer? Yes. Oh. Frostmourne from the World of Warcraft.
Digimon? Oh, never mind.
Oh, shit.
Game of Thrones had a bunch of cool swords. They were like the Wolf's Claw or something, or like.
Thunder Fury, Blessed Blade of the Windseeker. Yes, Kelly.
Y'all making up swords. What's the Windseeker?
Thunder Fury, Blessed Blade of the Windseeker is another World of Warcraft sword.
Oh. That makes sense. You think Mario's ever had a sword?
Yeah.
You do?
I reckon he's had a sword.
Really?
I guarantee it.
You guarantee it? That's...
I guarantee it. Do you know what? To Google.
But that's just like a... That's a very bold guarantee. Man, how am I missing so many Jinjos? How am I missing three of these fools?
I don't know if Google's having a fit, but the first auto-corrected thing is, has Mario ever wielded Kazooie?
That's a great question.
Mario Beam Sword was the blue-bladed beam sword that Mario used when fighting Smash Bros.
Oh,
Smash Bros.
I guess in Smash you can get a sword, yeah.
Nah, I don't think that counts, though.
Okay, where did you say that doesn't count? That's noble of you. Yeah, because in Mario RPG, he doesn't have a sword. He uses his fists, he uses a hammer, and he uses a shell.
Luigi's Beam Sword.
That sounds like a PG-13 thing.
No, this is from a video. That's from Stupid Mario Brothers.
Vintage Stupid Mario Brothers. That's right, Xor was the sword from Mario RPG. So the main villain in Mario RPG was a large talking sword. So maybe after that encounter, Mario was like, no more swords. I don't want to deal with swords.
Xor. I never want to see another sword in this kingdom again.
Xor is a real asshole, and I don't want to have to deal with him again.
Did he then ostracize all swords from the kingdom, meaning there will be a sword kingdom in Mario Odyssey 2?
That would be cool. Also, they should just make more Mario Odyssey games. Remember when Nintendo made Mario
Odyssey? Mario Odyssey is so good.
They gave it rich and compelling. I do love flips. Well, flips are great. This walrus is very scared because I'm a bear. It is funny that the walrus is scared of me because I'm a bear, because bears will eat walruses. So, like, understandable why the walrus doesn't want anything to do with me. Mm. And Casey said all these fantasy swords have nothing in comparison to anime ones. Listen, I respect that.
Fair. No, actually, no. Name an anime sword.
The poke blade.
Pokemon? Fuck yeah! I love it when Ash stabs Misty to death.
That's why Ash's run on Pokemon is ending, is because he killed Misty. He needs to go on the lam, all across the Kanto region. Yeah, that's right. I know where Pokemon takes place.
Well, literally Pokemon Sword, like.
Oh, that whole game had that name. Oh, Demon Slayer. He's got a cool sword.
But what's it called? Is it called Demon Slayer's sword? There's also a really cool sword in JoJo's Luck and Pluck. That's all right. Fair. Anime swords,
JoJo's
pretty legit.
Luck and Pluck.
Yeah, all of the main characters in JoJo's are named after bands or songs.
Is Luck and Pluck a band or a song?
It's a song, I believe.
Okay.
Like one of the main villains in season 2 of JoJo's is called AC/DC.
Oh, that's the name of the band, AC/DC.
Yeah, right?
Oh, this dude, I mean, I'm stuck in this loop with this fucking bear again. And he wants to race me now as a bear. He's fine, he's not racist anymore.
What
he wants to race me as a bear. But the problem is, I need the ability to don those tennis shoes, which will make me fast enough to be able to beat him. And I don't have that ability yet. You get in the next
level. Are the tennis shoes there? Are they just there now because...
It's to sort of clue you in, because those are power-ups that are only at specific places in levels. And the game kind of has like a... I keep doing this. Oh, I keep trying to get through his dialogue and accidentally hitting A instead of B, and then it puts me in the race again. This is a Christmas nightmare. This is an absolute Christmas nightmare.
Literally.
Yeah. This is an Ebenezer Scrooging. That's what this is. Okay, I'm going to get it this time. Oh, Banjo-Kazooie looks so sad. You guys are fine. Okay, hit B. The problem is A is both the accept race button and please talk faster button. And so I kept wanting them to talk faster. And by keep wanting them to talk faster, I kept prolonging my existence in that loop. So let me just tell you, I was hoisted by my own petard.
Goddamn.
Yeah.
Terrible UI. This is the thing. My next video... I've confirmed with Nick. My next video is on game UI. and why most of it is utter wank, especially in AAA.
Utter wank! A lot of AAA games I've played recently, God of War, very bad UI.
Really bad UI, yeah.
Enjoyed the game, but let me get that UI out of here.
Mm-hmm.
I'm missing one of these Jinjos, and I don't know where... Maybe he's just going to freeze to death. Maybe I'll just let him freeze to death. Listen, if they want to be that hard to be found, then good luck.
Here's a question for you. Have you played A Hat in Time?
I've played a little bit of it. I need to go back and do a full playthrough. Like, Yahtzee claims it's like one of the best 3D platforms ever.
I agree. Especially the DLC. I think I can't remember exactly what it's called, but it's the cat one in the city. Somebody in chat will know the name better than me. But it is fantastic, and you can play it all multiplayer. It's great.
Okay, I like that. Kelly Engineering said I stepped away for 2 minutes and suddenly anime was invoked.
Yeah.
Alright, we've done most of the stuff in the Christmas level. Listen, we spent the first half of this stream in the Christmas level. We'll come back when we get the 10 issues so we can absolutely slaughter that bear
Christmas
race. We'll move on to the next stage. We'll see what comes after Christmas. What theme do you think comes after Christmas?
Yeah, right? Because I guess like the thawing.
The thawing!
The thawing is what I would say. What are you doing here, dog? Ludo.
Oh, what? That's right, Kitchen. It was I didn't get the Jinjo at the top of Mumbo's hut because I just transformed and I didn't climb to the top. All right, you did good. That's fine. I'll still move on to Gobi's Desert. It's a desert. It's Gobi's Desert.
New Year's, yeah. Valentine's Day. I don't know.
I don't think
Easter?
There's New Year's themed levels. Are there?
No, but I'm actually thinking Old Hunter's suggestion of Easter might be it. Because you can do like Easter levels where like you're collecting eggs and...
Oh, that'd be nice.
There's a bunny and stuff.
Christ on the cross. No, not Christ on the cross. Were we not on the same page?
Shashank, Marty is playing. I'm not playing. Look, hands-free.
Yeah, that's allowed you to just stand up and walk away and bring new treasures to the stream.
Yeah, like party rings.
Yeah, this is the first escapist stream where anyone's ever seen my gameplay. Because it's not the first one where I've played a game, because obviously we've done co-op streams and game night and everything. But first time I've ever streamed where I've done gameplay.
And I'm glad we waited, because it is absolutely marvelous.
I'm gonna be honest, it's making me tear up a little bit.
Uh-huh.
Also, I cut a bunch of onions in my spare bedroom beforehand, and so that could also have led to the tearing up. Is that not where you guys cut onions, spare bedrooms?
No, I cut them in the bathroom.
Like, cut them right.
I do it while I'm taking
Was it gonna be taking a shower?
I'm gonna use a phrase that one of my best friends uses. Which I find utterly disgusting, but also hilarious. So I was going to say, I like to cut onions while I'm also simultaneously curling one out. Curling one out is one of the worst ways to describe having a shit
ever. That is incredible.
Yeah, curling one out. So that's where I chop my onions.
That's really like evocative.
Yeah, it really is.
I activated a little warp. I feel good when I activate warps. And Jacob Lester has been a member for 19 months. Thank you so much. In early access saying, Jamate, want to learn how to make games. How should I start? Jamate's not even at his desk anymore. Oh, there he is.
Hey, hello. Somebody said game design.
I want to learn how to make games. How do I start? That wasn't me saying that. That was Jacob. I have no desire to make games because they seem difficult and I don't like doing difficult things.
Jacob Lester, thank you so much for the question. Ludo, can you not? I'm talking about jam design. All right, you can chill. Where to start? So that's a interesting question. And I want to make videos on this, actually. So, Ludo, you haven't squeaked that toy. Like,
in weeks, and now I'm on a stream.
Ludo's a Sony fanboy. That's the problem with Ludo. We're playing a first-party Xbox game. Ludo's like, more
she
like...
She keeps... Literally, I've closed my door so I can stream, and she keeps, like, busting it open and knocking the door down.
Like a little Kool-Aid man.
Where to start? It's an interesting question, and I want to make videos on this, because making games is made up of loads of different disciplines, right? So there's... To boil it down into its most simple form, there's art, there's sound, and there's programming. But then we can get deeper, and there's like game design, level design, Foley artists who make sound effects, there's music. Ludo! Oh my
god!
When those dogs are rocking, don't go knocking them, everybody. Rollback. No, this is not a Nintendo game. This is an Xbox game. Xbox owned the rights to the games. They have allowed Nintendo to put it back on Switch, but Xbox. Obviously,
okay,
originally
I'm back.
Launched on N64. That's why I played it in my weird Polish style. But yeah, and yes, I'm playing.
I've literally barricaded my door. It's built up of loads of different disciplines, so it's difficult to kind of point people in a direction if they want to start, because there's so many places you could start. So first of all, I'd ask yourself the question of like what interests you the most about making games, be it programming, art, sound, the actual design of them, and then take steps there. So the best thing you can do to start is watch videos, find some people on YouTube who talk kind of generally about game design, and just try and absorb as much of it as you can, and then try and figure out what you like. And then there are some really good courses that you can take. A lot of them are on Skillshare or other assorted learning platforms, to try and dip your toes into different aspects. And then after that, if you really want to, you can go to university, or if that's not something that's possible where you live, or for you financially and stuff like that. The best advice I could give you is just make something. It's going to be rubbish, but just start making.
With that attitude, it's
going to
be rubbish.
Yeah, well, fair.
It's also the first 100 things anyone has ever made in anything has been shit. And I can attest to that.
Like, my first ever games I made were absolute bollocks. And, like, the first videos I ever made were absolute bollocks. And I have that in evidence because I still have them all. So... It sounds like a bit of a cop-out, but just start. Start following some tutorials. I'd recommend some engines like Unreal Engine. It sounds really daunting because they pump out so many great visuals, mm-hmm. but it's really accessible, lots of good tutorials. Unity has some really, really good tutorials and get you started really easily. Also, like in Unreal Engine, they use nodes instead of like a programming language, which is a little bit more accessible if you don't program. And also programs like Godot. So the game I'm working on at the moment is being developed in Godot, which is a really powerful engine, really approachable. So lots of things. Also, like join, if you haven't already, Jacob, I have a personal Discord for like my show and like my content, and we discuss game design stuff in there all the time. And if you ever have any questions, there's me and a host of other people who are willing to answer. Mm-hmm. We're all here to help each other. So join that and then come hang out.
You can watch the show Mythic Quest. Do you think a lot of people learn about game design from Mythic Quest?
I haven't watched Mythic Quest. It's the same thing in the sense of like I don't watch shows about magic because like as in magicians.
Yeah.
Because it pisses me off because so much of it is wrong.
What about the hit film Now You See Me?
Oh god, those films actually anger me. The Prestige though, fantastic.
The Prestige is just a great movie.
Yeah. It's sarcophagus. But I've heard from other developers that it's blanked. You said it 2 seconds ago.
Mythic Quest. I was mostly joking about that, but the show is pretty good and like isn't, especially if you get past the first couple episodes, like doesn't treat video games like a bullshit. Like it seems like folks on the staff actually understand how game development works. It's also made in conjunction with like Ubisoft, so that makes sense. Steve Brown says Hostile Grandma's said... Boy wasn't accurate. Grandma's Boy was great. Yeah. Did you ever see Grandma's Boy?
Hostile 7. I haven't seen Grandma's Boy. I don't know what that is. I guess I'll take a trip to Poland and read the Grandma's Boy strategy guide there for a month. Hostile 7 says they need my mother's maiden name. For game design purposes, apparently. Okay, I'm not sure I can give that away. Also, my mother's maiden name is actually funny. Like, it's actually hilarious.
Oh, I thought it was gonna
But
be
I'm
like,
not sure if that could be used to track me down, so I'm not gonna say it.
I thought you meant it was like actually like funny, F-U-N-N-Y. Like Doug Funny from the hit show, Doug.
That would be funny, wouldn't it?
Yeah. That would be funny. That would literally be funny. Because her name would be funny.
Lampy says, did I watch Breaking the Magician's Code? No, I don't know what that is.
Sounds like if you watch it, you fucking broke the code though, so probably shouldn't do that.
Yeah.
Is that Magician Code thing real?
Yeah.
Have you ever broken it?
Sorry?
Have you ever broken it?
No. Well, not necessarily. So, a lot of people don't realize this. So a lot of people have heard of the magic circle, right?
Sure.
But a lot of people don't understand that it, like, or know that it is actually real. It's not some kind of like secret society thing, right?
Yeah.
So within this, they have like libraries of tricks and things that are only accessible to the magic circle. And if you reveal that information, you're kicked out. That's in effect breaking the magician's code, right? I have a weird way of performing magic where it's not weird, but like I don't like being, you know, some magicians come across like, oh, I'm performing magic and I'm tapping into the spirit realm and all that bollocks. I'm really not into that stuff. I think that works on a very small percentage of people and is incredibly cringe to the rest. So I don't do that, and I never have. I'm very like sleight of hand focused, and making it very obvious that it's sleight of hand and that you can't see me doing the things, and that is the trick. And through that, I like to kind of, with specific tricks, explain how those things are done. So then I can then go and perform that trick on someone else, and the people I've just taught get to see it in action, and it's like another layer deeper.
Okay, I like that. You're a big fan of showing and teaching. Show and tell and teach.
Yeah, I've never really thought about it in that way, but yeah. Yeah, I think that's way more entertaining. Mm-hmm. And all the things I reveal are stuff that are well known. Like, one of the things I teach when I do performances and stuff. I have it here.
Show and
so
tell.
So there's a
show
book here. It's my tiny Bible version of it. But it's the expert at the card table. This book was written in 1902. And it is just a book full of card sleights and stuff like that, how to cheat at cards and stuff like that. And there's a way of palming cards in there that's... people have known this is readily available, this book. And you can learn the sleights, and you've been able to do it since 1902. And in some of my performances, I teach how some of them are done. But I'm not really revealing anything I learned at the Magic Circle, if you know what I mean.
Like, people don't get mad and say, like, you've doxed magician secrets. They're not going to ban
because,
you from Twitter.
No, because, all of the magicians that, like I just said, like, all of the magicians who know I'm kind of teaching that in my performance understand that those things have been available for over 100 years.
Public information.
So, it's not like... Because there are some things in the Magic Circle and, like, really rare things that, like, tricks and performances that are not well known, and you do kind of... You don't really get in trouble, like, you won't be killed, but, like, you do get in trouble if you reveal that information, right?
Because we banish to a new dimension.
It's closely guarded, right? So, yeah, I perform differently than to, you know, the top hat wearing... magic men.
Are you're anti-top hat in the act?
If you wear a top hat and I have a deck of cards in my hand, I will fly and kick the hat off you.
What if you do you have you ever worn a top hat in PG-13 times?
No, never ever.
Spice things up with like a big old top hat. Pull a rabbit out of it.
Pull something out of it. It's not rabbit.
A couple of people who came in. A couple of people who came in late seem very confused. The first hour of the stream, we were playing the Christmas level. We found everything we could in the Christmas level. Now we need to unlock an ability in the equally Christmas-themed desert level. And then we can go back to the Christmas level and wrap it up.
Well, it can be Christmas-themed wherever you are, because they still have Christmas in the desert, Mai.
Yeah, also think of this. This isn't a desert. This is Bethlehem.
Is Banjo-Kazooie like the Die Hard of video games, where it technically takes place at Christmas time? So Banjo-Kazooie is a Christmas game.
So Darren would say it's a Christmas game, and then Jack would be upset and make an infographic showing how it's not a Christmas game.
Is Jack one of those people who
Jack
doesn't believe
that? Jack is vehemently anti Die Hard as a Christmas movie.
Why so?
He made an entire infographic about it, how only whatever 15% of the movie acknowledges Christmas, and thus it just Christmas is just like a backdrop or like a window dressing. And I think he's being a real Grinch. That's what I think.
Yeah, honestly. Because why can't we just enjoy Christmas and terrorist murder? Honestly.
I wish this would have, if only Willow Week would have gone 1 week longer, we could have accosted him on it. Could have tag teamed him.
Oh my god. He could have been here like absolutely raging. He could have got his horn out.
Yeah, exactly, Frost. That's what we're doing in this level. We're searching for gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Myrrh?
Myrrh. Myrrh? What is myrrh?
Oh, if you don't know, you can't afford it, dog.
If you don't know, you can't afford it.
You can't afford my myrrh. It's probably some sort of spice. Well,
the spice is running.
Oh, shit. Bring him in. The wrong way.
Bring him in for Die Hard Week. Yeah. I'm sure he'd love that.
Side here. Great. All right, get inside the pyramid. You dumb. You ever been to a pyramid? You seem a guy who spent a lot of time.
No, I've never been to any pyramid in my life. Not yet, anyway.
Neither have I. I think going to Egypt would be cool. I think Egypt would be sick.
Oh, I'd love to go to Egypt. I'd love to see the pyramids. I have a book on Egypt right here.
You have a weird amount of things related. It feels like we've, like, came up with topics beforehand. We didn't.
No, we're just talking and I have things on it.
Bear, music, yo. So we're doing a memory game now. How are you with memory games?
Quite bad, I think.
Yeah, I'm pretty bad.
Egg.
I already forgot this.
They're all different.
We're looking for two pairs. I think I'm doing pretty good. I've already forgotten.
Yeah, you're doing pretty good.
One of my first boys. I think this was a Kazooie. And this was a Kazooie.
Hostile 7 highlighted a message over on Twitch and says, Jermaine, have you seen Nightmare Alley? No.
It's pretty good. That was
Guillermo
del Toro movie from last year. Kind of about like a traveling circus / carnival / freak show in like the early 1900s. People who try to use like magic and divination to trick people out of money.
That sounds cool as hell.
Pretty good, yeah. They definitely break the magic code in that movie.
Do they?
Well, they
wow, this has got a lot of people in it.
Yeah,
really,
it does. Got B. Cooper?
Not the B. Coops.
Oh, B. Coops. Little Rocky Raccoon.
The Willem Dafoes as well.
Oh, my God. Willem Defriend or Willem Dafoe?
Oh, my God.
That's a game I play every time he shows up in a movie. Is he playing Willem Defriend or Willem Dafoe? And it's usually Willem Dafoe, if I'm being honest.
It's nearly always Willem Dafoe.
He's always a, like, once you go full goblin in a movie like he did in Spider-Man, it's tough to go back.
If you go full goblin, I'm honestly, you're probably going to get typecast for the rest of your life.
On episode of Breakout recently, Casey and I had to try to explain to Nick what goblin mode was, which that was a highlight of my week.
Okay, full goblin mode.
Yeah, we had to teach him about goblin mode.
did he get it?
I think he got it by the end. I mean, most of our... When he kept asking what goblin mode was, I would be like, oh no, it's like when you're going full goblin. So my explanations weren't very good, to be honest.
He says, what's goblin mode? And you're like, well, you know, goblin mode.
Yeah, you know, goblin mode. full goblin.
You know, goblin mode.
Yeah, when you're gobbling out.
Hey, Dimitri, how you doing?
Welcome, welcome. Lampy with a highlight message says, am I going to try the final level of this game again? I loved it. I did not. This game is a real shit final level. It is a quiz. But it's not a quiz based
about
on
this.
Things you would like normally know from the game. A bunch of it is you have to talk to a good witch who's scattered about the game, and she'll give you a bunch of fun facts, and you just need to like learn the fun facts. And let me tell you, having that be the end of the game is just a real... It puts a real wrinkle in your croissant. Has anyone ever said
that?
Yeah,
that does sound
pretty
grim.
Is that a saying? Real wrinkle in your croissant?
Yeah, that's said all the time.
Yeah.
In Spain, specifically.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Esperanza. I don't know. Yeah, I'm not sure if I'd eat a wrinkly croissant if I'm being 100% honest. You brought me a wrinkly croissant, I'd say thank you, but no thank you.
I'd just eat it because I'm going to be honest. Croissants are made of like layers and layers and layers of puff pastry, right?
Yeah.
So I probably wouldn't be able to notice a wrinkle in it.
Sure. Also, you're going full goblin mode there.
Yeah.
If you're eating a wrinkly croissant, that's living the goblin mode.
Oh, you are vehemently in goblin mode and you're getting typecast for the rest of your life.
Okay.
Frost says, that's why Platoon was so good. Defoe was always the bad guy up to that point, and Tom Berenger, or whatever his name was always the hero.
There you go. See, sometimes you need to subvert expectations.
Yeah,
like
definitely.
Willie D.
The big weedy.
The big weedy. Okay, I learned my running shoe ability from Goggles the Mole. People, so Goggles has big. He's got big glasses on because he's blind. And he wears like a red cardigan. And one time I was wearing a red cardigan and someone said I looked like Bottles the Mole. That was a pretty sick bird.
I'm currently wearing a red jumper and wearing glasses.
Yeah. You don't got big like Coke bottle glasses like I do though, do you? Look how bad.
No. Well, they're quite big.
Yeah, I got real shit eyes.
Got real shit eyes?
I got real shit eyes, yeah.
My eyes are okay. I really need to go get my glasses changed, but I'm just really lazy.
Yeah, I'm in that same category. My glasses have that thing where it's like the enamel is coming off them because I have like protective enamel, and so it's all like scratchy, and I gotta get that fixed.
Gotta get that shit fixed. That hand had that jiggy for 1,000 years.
Yeah. And I couldn't get it until I was able to get the power to run fast. And so,
Think
about that. If you ever go to Egypt and you really want to sort of fuck some stuff up, just run fast.
A lot of things can be solved by running fast as well. A lot
great.
Of math equations.
Yeah. Yeah, that checks out.
Yeah, yeah. Hostile's highlighted message says, Marty, would you put this game in the category of Games for Impact?
We were talking about the Game Awards. There's a category called Games for Impact, which in my mind, I'm like, I could understand what this would be. Like games with like a message that are actually like, you know, impactful or doing something in accessibility.
Yeah.
Like before your eyes, I would be like, that's a game that like...
That's a game for impact, yeah.
But the game that won it at the Game Awards this year was As Dusk Falls. Which A has no like message to it, and B is fucking sucks. Oh, I got right to the top and then didn't get in.
What's that? What's that incest game? That's got impact.
12 minutes.
12 minutes. Yeah, that's
a got
game
impact.
That's not a game for impact. That's a game for incest.
That's a new category. 2023 Game Awards. Best sister kisser. I think it's unfair that I hit a switch and it gives me 25 seconds to get to where it needs to go. But for the first 5 seconds of that, it's an unskippable cutscene showing where I need to go. And the clock is running. And so what are we doing here, Banjo? What are we doing?
Oh, we've just got some urgent information. Nick said, just popping in to say hey, and that we won't have time to do Halo today. Got an event to go to tonight. Have to run some errands and now get my ankle checked for a sprain. Marty can explain why.
I can't explain why. So Nick has a new... Also, what do we think an event is, first off? I can't explain what the tonight's event is, but I'll leave that to Nick. Everyone can sound off in the comments below what you think.
It must involve canapes, because events have canapes.
Canapes! So, Nick's ankle. Very serious.
Yeah.
Nick obviously has a new dog, Barry. Barry is wonderful. Barry could be a little bit of a rascal. Nick realized Barry has been floofing around a fence that Nick has, and kind of digging around, scratching around. Nick's a little worried they could, you know, get through the fence and that'd be terrible. And so while Nick was kind of like looking at the fence and trying to figure out what we're going to do about this, I don't know. I can't explain the exact logistics of it, but it sounds like the fence fell over and he fell over the fence and landed in mud and hurt his ankle. So
it involves fences, Nick, and mud,
yeah,
and falling.
And when he told me that, the only thing I wanted more than anything in life itself was video of this, which I don't think happened, unless Nick has a security camera, in which case, can we make that a stretch goal to release the Muddy Buddy cut?
The Muddy Buddy cut. Yeah, I'm keen.
So yeah. He's definitely going downtown. Yeah. There's no way that event isn't downtown, first off.
Yeah, it's definitely downtown.
Yeah, no one has uptown events.
Oh, Nick's chimed in. No, lol, Barry got out of the fence this morning, and I had to hop the fence to get him. And my ankle got caught on the fence jumping back over, and I busted it. Yeah, yeah, that's a lot worse.
Yeah, and his pants tore in half, and he was wearing boxers with hearts on them, and everyone saw. The cute girl next door he has a crush on saw and pointed and laughed, and the audience hooted and hollered, and then they went into commercial break. He didn't mention that stuff, but I assume that was like the flavoring.
Yeah.
Also, can we talk about how he says Marty can explain, and then he didn't even give me time to explain, and he explained himself?
Well, no, Marty, that's not what happened. just like with what you just described, you described a different event, and then Nick explained the actual event.
Oh, I thought it was pretty similar. What are we talking? I talked about Barry and the dog and
and you said that Nick was like trying to like sort the fence out. Not that his dog did escape and he had to hop the fence, and then like coming back,
did
like
I get it wrong?
He saved his dog from potentially getting killed by getting through the fence. You described it as if he was just tinkering with the fence and it fell on him.
That's kind of what I thought. I thought he was like climbing the fence. Listen, the message came right before I went live. I'm gonna be honest. I had the jimmies about getting the stream going. This is the first time I just got a lot of moving pieces. Your boy had the jimmies. I feel fine now, though.
Jimmy Hell yeah. Fun. Yeah, Nick said, none of that happened. I'm just glad I didn't faceplant into dog shit.
I thought he became a muddy buddy. He definitely said something about being a muddy buddy.
I mean, I'm sure he did become a muddy buddy when he caught his ankle on the way back.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't think the muddy buddy's in dispute.
No. Also, between muddy buddies and curl one out, I don't know, this has been weird. It's been a weird couple hours.
Yeah, there's always a theme, isn't there?
Yeah. Oh, shit. How do I get to the top of this palm tree? Yeah, so there's a messed up little event. Your camel is hanging out here, and you got to ground pound the camel to spit out a bunch of water so that the plant grows.
That's horrible. Literally.
Barry Houdini. I like the idea of Barry Houdini. That the dog escaping is Barry Houdini.
Yeah.
You can't say none of that happened. Several of the parts of the story happened.
Quite a lot of the parts.
There was definitely
happened.
There was some creative liberties specific, taken, but it's called Spice of Life, my friend.
Yeah.
Flying going on. What kind of shit do we got? I think we got to do some. We got to fly through some shit. I don't know.
Oh, Nick's come back in with the facts. He says he got into a fight with Master Chief as he was trying to steal Barry, and he threw me away by my ankle. See, now that's fictitious, because if you actually met the Master Chief, you'd cry.
Yeah, you wouldn't finish that fight.
Not
in 100,000 years.
You'd be in awe to meet your hero. So
also,
you'd be like, I love you.
What's Master Chief doing stealing dogs?
Huh?
What's Master Chief doing stealing dogs?
Well, have you not read the fifth book in the series? It's the only way he can get sustenance. He eats them.
He eats dogs. They omitted that canon. from the Paramount Plus series.
Yeah. No, if you look closely, he is eating a dog in everything.
Yeah, even the scene where he bones out.
Mm-hmm.
I remember, Nick bought that. Nick owns that as a steel case.
Nick owns everything, though. I respect it, because like I collect a lot of things as well. But like every movie that I've ever heard of, in the next few weeks of a movie coming out, I will hear about Nick getting the Blu-ray of it.
To be fair, I usually make fun of him for it, but with more and more stories of things being taken off, like HBO Max, like Westworld and The Nevers and stuff like that, I'm like, maybe Nick's actually onto something.
I'm a big. We've had this debate a lot, I'm a big physical boy. Yeah,
I'm a big physical boy.
I'm a big physical boy. You're a big digital boy.
Yeah, I'm a big digital boy.
Yeah. I like collecting things. I counted my Switch games the other day. I have like 50.
You got 50 Switchers?
I got 50 Switch A's. I mean, you guys can...
I
do
didn't
this
think
my
they
camera.
Made 50 Switch games.
All of these and those. Switchers.
That's so many Switchers.
And Nick says next design delve is how much Master Chief is how Master Chief automatically regenerates health by eating dogs. it's a good follow up to the FromSoft video, honestly.
I also love the idea of you doing that with your like design delve voice, like just like a very like, you know, your serious studious
voice. See, because I never realized I do a voice, like I don't put anything on.
Oh no,
it's just like
my VO absolutely sounds different than
it's very different. And like people who know me in real life and have like heard me speak for years watch my videos and go like, you sound really weird. But most of the people who watch my show, like, that's just what I sound like.
I mean, that's also like Yahtzee doesn't talk at fucking 10,000 words per second on streams.
That yeah, it's true. In fact, it's actually the opposite on streams.
Yeah, he's
very,
very slow and
soft-spoken, slow. Yeah. Beer Bomb, member for 11 months, thank you so much, says, Merry Christmas to the best video game bear.
Wait, was Beer Bomb the best Christmas bear, or the best video game bear, or is Banjo? Because Beer Bomb, you're great. Beer Bomb, you're right up there with Banjo.
Agreed.
I mean, I like Banjo. I never took the Beer Bomb Player's Guide with me to Poland and read it in the outhouse, but...
Not yet.
I keep talking about reading in the outhouse. I never read it in the outhouse because the outhouse was dark because it was an outhouse.
Yeah, but I'm sure you did at one point take it with you. If it was that much of a precious item.
I don't think it did the outhouse. I wasn't afraid of like my grandma stealing it. She didn't speak English.
I would be. My grandma used to steal my player guides all the time.
Is that why?
My grandma's still kicking them out.
Is that who you modeled your D&D character after? Your granny?
Yeah. Susan Sheerfist is modeled after my player guide stealing gran. Cheshire did fan art of my
it looks incredible.
Of season. I loved it so
it
much. Cheshire is so talented.
Incredible. Cheshire is out of control.
Big shout out to Cheshire.
Hell yeah. Okay. We're here. We're going to be wrapping up. Desert level, we'll go back and beat that shitty bear.
Oh hell yeah, get that Christmas level done.
Get the Krimbus level done, and then before the end of the stream, maybe we'll take a little dabble into the spooky level.
Oh hell yeah. Cool. Ooh, I missed a highlighted message from Lampy.
Hello Lampy.
I like to believe that Nick hurt his ankle with the vacuum somehow.
Oh, he was talking about how he got a new vacuum and Barry was eating on one of the hoses. Barry sounds like a little Cujo, like a little rascal.
A little rascal, yeah. How, Nick, if you're still here, boss, how old is Barry?
115.
That'll be why. He just wants to pass on.
Just wants to die.
I'm going to jump over this fence so I can go to the...
Stop
yonder.
Going to your nighttime event. I just want to die.
Between 6 and 10 months. Okay, cool. Oh, are they a rescue? If you don't know the exact age.
Yeah, I imagine they're rescue dogs. That's, yeah. Seems like a rescue dog, kind of.
Nick is definitely a rescue rescue dog kind of guy. And as someone who owns a puppy, rescue dog people are better people. Honestly, this isn't even sarcasm. If you can rescue a dog, rescue a dog.
Yeah.
Hell yeah, rescue.
Hell's bells.
False. I haven't been rescued yet. Nick is still waiting to be rescued.
Well, yeah, because he got his pants caught on the fence and he's hanging upside down.
Oh, Nick's there currently.
Yeah, my story. Everyone thinks my story is fake, but my story.
Happening live.
Yeah.
Is the event Nick's going to the hospital?
It's like a support group for people who've had that exact. Extremely specific scenario happened to them. Yeah.
That would be a really weird place to find your doppelganger. Do you believe in like doppelgangers? Like, have you seen those pictures of people who've met basically just themselves?
Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah. I will say the same thing I say for a lot of paranormal and extraterrestrial stuff is I want like Mulder. I want to believe. I've never had an experience like that, but I'd like to believe that there's magic in the world.
Yeah, I agree.
Have you ever met a doppelganger?
No, but I'm also very fucking generic looking.
Yeah, like, that's my thing. It's like a lot of dudes just look like me because I'm just a white dude with a beard and glasses.
Yeah, I'm a white dude with glasses, a beard, and my hair's receding. Yeah. Like, there's a fuck ton of us.
Yeah.
Like... So I'm sure one day I will meet someone who just like looks like me, mm-hmm. Like to the T. But also, it would freak me out more if they like sounded like me.
Yeah, that'd be kind of freaky.
Yeah, that would be the big freak.
I'd watch it. Would you watch a movie called The Big Freak?
100%. I'd watch that on repeat.
Like what? That's what the Hulk's name should have been. Big Freak.
The Big Freak.
The Incredible
yeah.
Hulk. Just Big Freak.
The big freak. The big F.
The big F. Alright, I'm gonna race Boggy now. I'm gonna wrap up this
Go on,
level.
I'm gonna race Put on Boggy. Those shoes.
Yeah, I'm putting on the shoes. This is gonna be tough. He's like a he's a real rascal.
Snake of the Garden says, how long till I shave my head? Right, hey. Okay, I am going through that period of I'm 28 now, right? So my hair's I've got a proclivity because of my grandparents, my dad. That my hair is receding, right? I'll show you. I'll literally show you guys my hairline, right? Like, it's getting thin in the front, right? And I'm chill with that, and I'm fine with getting a little, they call it like a widow's peak when it's like pointed in the front. I'm chill with that. I'm fine. I'll deal with that. The only time I'll shave it is if I get like an island at the back or I get
like a
little island at the front.
Yeah.
Then it's gone. And I'll just grow my beard out because, like, at uni, I had a beard down to here.
Really?
Yeah. I had a big beard, so I know I can do it. So I'll just shave my head, grow my beard out, and just like get fucking buff as fuck, and I'll just become a lumberjack.
You become Kratos.
Yeah.
You'll get bad UI.
Yeah. Hey, I've got to save my UI talk for the next video. Oh god.
You need to put a picture of you with a big beard in Discord. I can't picture you the big
I'll find one. I'll do it right now.
Find a good one. Find a good one. Or a bad one.
Jesus, my phone light's on. Jeez. I will do it now.
Speaking of, you have an iPhone, I'm assuming?
Yeah.
I don't know why I assumed that, but you have an iPhone. Did an update a little while ago for you and anyone in chat change the way notifications look on your home screen and they all appear at the bottom?
Yes.
Going to the top?
I agreed.
And I can't... there's no way to just go back.
No, there's not. And I tried to change it. And I remember sitting down with my housemate and being like, oh, they fucking moved the notifications. That's so fucking annoying. Why can't I move them? And he has an Android and like he smugly said, oh, well, it sucks to be an iPhone user because I can move my notifications. And I was like, oh, can you? Go on then. And then he looked and he can't. Twat. Like, Android users like to shit on iPhone users, but you can't do it either. I'll find a picture of me.
Why? What are we changing? Why are we changing things? Deebs, with a member message after 22 months saying, just wants the beard pics.
I'm okay. I'm I'm getting beard pics. Come on.
Send beards.
What the fuck?
What the fuck?
There's a new feature on iPhones where I just tried to copy a picture. Do you know, like, you hold down and it comes up with a submenu?
Yeah.
But I just held down on myself and it, like, fucking digitally scanned just me.
Nope, don't like it.
Saying I can just copy that part of me.
Don't like that. Don't like that. What's going
That's
on
That's weird. Let's put this in Discord.
All sorts of crazy critters. Chris S with $2 dono said, I'm going to be humming this theme all day now. Good. There's worse things to hum.
Definitely.
Can't think of any, but I'm sure there's worse.
Oh, I'm going to go to Discord. Discord. Not only mates. I want to go to Marty.
I think only mates is a very funny name for your Discord. Oh,
yeah, I was thinking about changing it today to like Design Delvers or something, but only mates is a what there's we... me with not that's not the peak of how long it was, but like that's a picture of me with a longish beard.
What prompted you to
I basically I have this thing where if I have a beard sometimes it irritates people and it like makes them itch. It doesn't make me itch at all. I always find like with growing a beard, there's like this
introductory period.
Length. Yeah, there's a length it gets to where it's like ungodly itchy, and then it gets past it and it never itches again.
Yeah.
And I grew it out, and I at uni, and it got really big. And then I have this thing where like at the corners of my mouth here, when I get nervous, I don't know why, I like pick the hairs out of the corner of my beard.
Okay.
It's weird. I don't know why. But
nervous tick. A lot of people have those.
It's like a nervous tick, and I would like pluck the hairs out of just these bits, and I would do it so much that it like really annoyed me, and I'd be like, this is dumb. Why do I keep doing this? Yeah. And I went, do you know how I'm going to stop it? I'm just going to shave my beard.
There you go.
I shaved it before a friend from America came to visit, and a friend of mine was picking me up at like 4 a.m. and he'd never seen me without a beard, and I shaved it like right down, completely gone. And in the headlights at like 4 a.m. I walked up to his car and I could hear him screaming in his car, like like horrified because he didn't know who I was.
Incredible.
But yeah, like if I ever go fully bald, I will grow it out again. I've been thinking about it actually to grow it out again, but it's Casey says he does that too. Yeah, I don't know what it is. It's just like a weird tick. I don't know why. Yeah. Deebs says, Jay beard picks, please. Maybe I'll put it in Only Mates.
Yeah, you gotta charge for that.
Yeah, 100%. If you go on, I'll put it on Patreon, guys. There's also the new episode of Design Delves on Patreon, so.
So if you want beard
check
picks
it out.
Or Design Delve.
Yep. Whatever takes your fancy. Sure. Dimitri says that my plan for my hairline fully receding is also the same as theirs. That's fair.
There you go.
Chris S with $2, thank you very much, says, I'm going to be humming this theme tune all day now.
It's a good one.
Yeah, it's really cool what they've done with the music. What's this picture of Nick at the Canadian border, Lampy?
Well, excuse me, Nick at the Canadian border?
I want to see this.
Was it the last time he was allowed in Canada before the incident?
Yeah. We don't talk about the incident.
Oh, shit. I think I fucked up. I talked about the incident.
Yeah. I'm sorry. You have to be terminated.
Oh, no. Like the Terminator movie? Because that's bad.
Yeah. Like Terminator 3. Judgment.
Rise
Squirt,
of the Machines.
Whatever it's called.
Rise of the Machines.
Rise of the Machines. The Vancouver photo. See, that sounds like a secret X-Files thing.
Yeah. Do you have do you have information related to the Vancouver photo?
No, we haven't revealed any new information on the Vancouver photo yet, but we're searching. We have our best men on it. Oh no, it's top men, isn't it?
our top men.
Top men.
All right, we're unlocking Spooky Town.
See you in a bit, Noah. Have a good one.
Bye, Noah. Did Nick try to illegally enter Canada to play hockey? I can see that. I unlocked Mad Monster Mansion, so we'll get a little taste of the spooky for you on the stream. What do you think the transformation is in the spooky level? It's a haunted mansion. So in the ice level, it was a walrus. In a level, it's a big hill. It's a termite. What do you think?
It's a big pumpkin.
You already got it. It's a pumpkin.
Oh. I thought this was a trick question.
It wasn't. I was literally trying to, like, ask you what you thought the theme was. And, yeah, you nailed it. Well done.
Nick just sent me the Vancouver picture. That is the best picture I've ever seen. I agree, Lampy. Nothing tops that. Holy shit. Nick, thank you so much.
The Vancouver picture. I'm afraid to touch it. I can't because I can't open. I can't touch anything. So if I touch anything, you'll go.
I was gonna say something before I saw that completely threw me off.
You can say whatever you want. It's your special day.
Oh, Brolbrack says I want an anatomy on Banjo-Kazooie. Well, you're not in luck because that show doesn't exist anymore. It's. Yeah, so Design Delve is the new show. So, yeah, I might do a Design Delve on Banjo-Kazooie. Why not?
Yeah, I can do that. I'm going to do it. Don't fucking lie to them. Don't lie to them.
Right? Hey, I already said that. I wanted to do a collab with you. Like,
and I already said we will never collab again. And then I told people to tune
in. Did you? I didn't see that in chat.
Oh, yeah,
it
was a joke. I said we will never collab again. And then I said tune in to our stream in an hour. A little goof.
What a goof, dude. Because I was going to say, dude, we're collabing right now.
This is just raw collabing. I don't want to say raw collabing. That's not gross.
Oh, Nick. Yeah, never retake that picture, Nick. That's absolute gold. Absolute gold. Describe the photo. Okay, I'll describe it.
And Dingus asks, is that the one where Nick looks like a serial killer? Does he look like a
serial
killer?
No, I would say he looks like a serial killer. Okay, I will describe the Vancouver photo in vague terms to not invoke the old ones, the old gods. So it's like a really low resolution kind of black and white photo of like a snapshot, right? Of like for I don't know, like a passport or like a driver's license or something like that, but it looks like it was taken in like an office, and it's Nick looking incredibly surprised.
The one where he looks like
he's gonna be attacked.
Yeah, okay.
But it's so good.
Yeah, I remember that. It was when he came. It was at the airport. He needed to take a photo, and they wouldn't let him retake it.
It's so good. Marty's seen it.
I know the one. He shared it in a Discord thread that we have a Monday call every week, and then every Monday for like the next 2 months, when that call would start, I would have to see that picture again because it was like the last message in that Discord thread.
Amazing. Top men. Yes, Speakeasy. Yes.
Top men.
I need to rewatch Indiana Jones, just the trilogy. All right, we'll see if chat agrees with this. I really like Temple of Doom.
Oh, so do I.
Sick.
No, I don't like it as much as the other two, but. I think it's an extremely fun movie.
Yeah, I'll agree. Yeah. I always heard it's one of those movies where like I've heard about a lot of people hating it, but nobody I know hates it.
So is this all like manufactured hate?
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. It's like I hear a lot about people hating The Last Jedi, but like, we were on stream the other day, and me, you, and Jack all quite
Darren
like it.
Darren just wrote a piece about how he loves it. So, no one, Darren's never wrong.
That literally contractually obliged to not be wrong.
Yeah, I feel like there's a lot of pressure.
It is. He has a lot of fact checking in his videos of his opinions.
Every time a movie comes out, he's like, "Oh God, I better be right on this."
Oh, Nick spent the picture in live stream discussions. Go check it out, guys, in the Escapist Discord. Beautiful. If you're not in, we have a lot of fun over there.
Oh, I woke up a ghost. The sleeping ghost is named Napper. It's a good name for a sleeping ghost.
It's a very,
If you had a ghost,
Bagul is a good name for a ghost.
Bagul?
Or a demon. Bagul.
Bagul. What would you name if you had a ghost? What would you name
it? Terry.
Scary Terry.
Scary Terry.
Yeah.
Or, I'd call him something like really weird. Like, I always feel like if you say the name of a ghost or a demon, it like invokes them, right?
Sure,
like,
sure.
They're there. So I'd want something really obscure, so, something that I know only my enemies would say. Mm. Like, what would my enemies say? Skyrim is good.
Skyrim is good. Yeah. Pass the paprika, please.
Yeah, literally.
Love paprika.
Yeah, my enemy, literally, it's just a fact.
Yeah.
When I went to Budapest, which is famous for its paprika,
yeah, it is.
I had to watch my back so much because it was just full of my enemies.
Yes, because Potato Salad Paul was there, and we all know Potato Salad Paul. He's a paprika boy.
He really is, yeah. That's first. That's literally the top thing on his CV.
Yeah. For those in the US, a CV is like a resume.
Oh, yeah, sorry. You're,
No, I was just making sure people know, like, people in the US can watch out for paprika Paul.
Yeah, I was just about to like chat shit about like the word resume, but then I realized I don't actually understand what like CV stands for.
Yeah, I don't know anything. I think all the words are dumb.
Agreed, especially the ones we're using right now.
Yeah. I've said this before. I think we need to come to an agreement. I am fine adopting the metric system, but we need to use Fahrenheit instead of Celsius. I'm fine with everything. We can put use
Why
in the word
is
favorite.
Fahrenheit better than Celsius?
We can put use in the word favorite. We can put use in the word color. That's fine. We can call elevators lifts. That's fine. We just need to agree that Fahrenheit's better because it's a bigger.
Is Fahrenheit better than Celsius?
First off, it's a bigger spectrum to play with. It's like a larger playground.
Yeah, but when are you ever gonna go over those levels?
First off, it adds more specificity to it. And also, when it's hot outside, what temperature is it for you? Say, oh man, it's hot. It's really hot out here.
If it's really hot, it's like 30, between 30 and 40 degrees.
Oh, really? Because it's 85 degrees here, Jay. Doesn't that sound hotter? Doesn't that sound scarier?
It sounds hotter, but that doesn't make it better.
No, but it sounds better.
Because what is freezing in Fahrenheit?
32.
32. That why freezing, like free the freezing point of water and the freezing is zero.
Is 32? Yeah, it's 32 degrees.
You know, it's zero because it's Celsius is the states of water. It's zero is freezing and 100.
Why are we basing our temperature on the whims of big water?
Because we're made of like 95% water, and it's the main thing we all consume in life.
I'm all 4 degrees. I'm degrees till I die.
I honestly think your brain might be a few degrees off,
the
mate.
Thing
to the
I
left.
Think is insane is I'm willing to concede every other measurement, and you won't even give a centimeter. See what I did there?
Yeah.
See what I did there? Because it's the phrase is
given
inch.
You say I won't give a kilometer. you can use whatever you want. Like, I don't give a shit. Like, I've never understood the argument for Fahrenheit.
Oh, dude, because the bigger the number is, big number goes boom.
So, because your strongest argument right now is Fahrenheit's better because it makes hot temperatures sound scarier.
Yeah.
That's your biggest argument.
Goddamn right it is. Case closed. I rest my case. What other argument do I need? 30? Oh, I got heat stroke in 30 degrees. Get the fuck out of here.
Marty's made of 70% weeb. That's why he doesn't get it. Yeah.
Did you say weed or weeb? Is that an A? I got a spell and the camera's being a real gadzooks.
Dingus Van Sant says, with highlighted messages over on Twitch, says Fahrenheit 451 is better than Celsius 233.7.
Crushed it, Dingus.
Nice literary joke. I appreciate it.
An American Fear resub with Prime. Been a member for 18 Ooh. Months. Saying Fahrenheit equals just freedom units. Let's call them freedom units. That sounds great.
Mm. It's also like the other arguments of like, so we drive on the left side of the road, mm-hmm. and you drive.
We
on
can do that too.
Right.
That's fine. I'll take all that.
No. I agree. I think we should be driving on the right.
Okay.
I used to think I was raised thinking that a lot of the world drove on the left. It was just Americans that drove on the right, but it's actually the opposite.
It should
most be. Places drive on the
like most
right,
things should
don't.
Just be democratic, right? It should just be like, all right, most of the world does the metric system, so we should do the metric system, except when it comes to degrees. Cause. Also, think about this. Put this in your thought bubble and smoke it.
Right.
How come we have different measurements of everything except time? How come there's like not multiple different measurements of time? How come there's no Fahrenheit to Celsius of time, or kilometer to mile of time?
I've watched a video on this and I'm just too dumb to quote it, but it's something to do with racism. Yes, because bringing over, like forcibly bringing over different cultures and like how that all happens and stuff. There's people like Shark Bunny or says there's different calendars, which is a different form of measuring time.
I guess that that's true, but they're all sort of like I want to know like what the metric second is. Like this stream goes on for 2 hours. How long does it go for in metric time?
Well, this is the thing.
You'd be like, oh, it's,
whenever
no,
time
it's 15,
is concerned,
this stream is 15 jimmies. It's
whenever 15, time is concerned, yeah. Right? I've had this conversation with Yahtzee. Time was invented in England, right?
Get the fuck out of here.
So,
out of here with this bullshit.
We own it. Time is invented. By definition, me and Yahtzee are Time Lords.
Absolute horseshit. Time was invented in England. Who do you think you are?
British Standard Time.
Was that the first thing?
We are. It's all centralized down in England. Big Ben is where time was invented.
Large Benjamin did it himself?
Yeah, Big Benny, that's where it happened.
Oh, where am I going? Oh, I think I fucked this up. Oh, no, I didn't fuck this up. Never mind. I'm unfuckable. Unfuck-up-able. I'm unfuckable. Crushed it. I didn't go through the door!
Gosh darn it.
Beast March with Filer Dono said, Fahrenheit rules and centigrade is boring. Merry Christmas and thanks for all the great content this year. Oh, thank you. And thanks for being right. I know it's tough to be right sometimes.
Yeah, it is. Fahrenheit's just a dumb word as well, isn't it?
But Celsius... I bet it had something. I bet like the fucking queen created Celsius, and that's why you guys love it.
Yeah, centigrade makes sense, right? Because it's centi, which is 100, I believe, and grade, which is we're grading it. It's the 100 grade.
Yeah, definitely.
I believe
100 grade definitely.
Fahrenheit.
Yeah, when I'm
sweating. Fahrenheit looks like I spelt it right, and I'm dyslexic as fuck.
Yeah.
Fahrenheit doesn't look like it could be spelled.
Hey, if
like
we
that.
Want to talk about changing the spelling of Fahrenheit, I'm game for that, because that word.
All right,
that
do you know what? If we can change the spelling.
So we'll adopt Fahrenheit, but we can spell however you want.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. We'll spell it like C-E-N-T-I-G-R-I-D-O.
You're doing it! How dare you? I was tricked. It just feels like this is one of those deals like it would be silly of you not to take. I'm offering you other units of measurement. Like
that. I just respect that you feel I have the power to accept this deal, and it just happened.
Are you not the King Angle?
Well, technically, yes. But off the books, no. Matthew says, Celsius was invented by someone who hates people with lisps. Celsius.
I'm talking to a big hand. There's a ghost hand that plays an organ. You know what his name is? His name is Moat's Hand.
Mo! Love it.
Playing a little game of Simon now.
Ah, Lampy got me with the British facts, as he usually does.
Yeah, but Lampy lies a lot, so we don't know if it's real.
Fair. Lampy says, metric time is already real, Marty. Jay, British Standard Time doesn't exist. It's Greenwich Mean Time and British Summer Time. I got them mixed up.
What's metric time? Metric time, is that real?
Metric time? That's just I think it's just time.
Is that just time? Yeah, I just want a different... Doesn't
but
need
what
to be.
Is time? Honestly.
It's same thing that a dog is.
Thinking of relativity, right? If I got on a spaceship and went at the speed of light, would England still exist?
I mean, as long
checkmate
as
it.
As long as Large Benjamin's still there to protect it.
Checkmate, atheist.
This game hinges on a lot of Simon-based memory puzzles.
It does. They're very easy to design.
Yeah. But they become tough when. Do I have to do it again? They become tough when I'm looking at chat and then I'm not paying attention to what happens, and then I look back and I realize I just missed what just happened. So not great. So maybe part of that is on me. Was this game in 1998 not designed for people who were also looking at chat at the same time?
Does this hand play the melody of the song that's been playing throughout the game?
No, it would be awesome if it did. I mean, maybe it does. Like, I don't know what
honestly.
Because these notes aren't playing anything... like they're just playing the same tone, but like maybe if you played them on like a real piano.
Cause that makes me a bit ill.
Am I fucking like up? If it doesn't. What am I doing? Am I doing it right? Did I win? Am I winning some? Yeah, like, Lars, I don't know why all the keys are making the same sound. Oh, I did win.
I do a lot of useless shit in my videos, right? Like a lot of really unnecessary editing things and like that no one's ever going to notice, but like it's satisfying to me, so I do it. And one of the hardest ones I've ever done is in my Half-Life video, which is on the Escapist, there's a section where I'm playing a piano in VR and I'm playing the chords to the song that's playing in the video in time with the music in the video.
Did literally anyone notice it?
No. Not a
but
single
you,
person.
But you noticed it, so that's the important thing.
Yeah, like I'm sure if you guys go back and look at the video, I'm sure somebody in chat now will be like, I noticed. But yeah, I play the music
that's
while it's in the video. It's just dumb. I shouldn't have done it.
So it shows you care.
But hey, whatever.
Fuck that up. Incredibly. Rarely have I messed something up as much as I just did there.
Oh god. That's yeah, that was.
You know what? I'm just gonna leave this place. I don't know. Whatever. You can have it. I don't need all that shit. Whatever. We're gonna be done in 10 minutes, and I'm just gonna throw my Series X out in the snow, anyways.
Casey says, "Do that sort of thing all the time. It's thankless effort for sure." Yeah, but like I've always done it, even in my early videos on my own channel, because I always had the theory of. When you start out on your own channel, like you're literally scrounging for every subscriber and every view. And I always thought like the more little tricks and things I put in my edit, like one of them might be the reason that someone subs.
Someone's like, oh, this is like the thing that differentiates you from the next person.
Yeah, or like they might just notice it and go, oh, that's neat. that's cool. I'll give him a sub, and like, so I just used to try and put as many as I could in, which means my editing would take a lot longer, but yeah. They're fun to make as well, you know. Or Lampy with some more information or lies, we don't know.
Could be both.
Metric time is an international system of units measurement and has such cool units as decasecond, hectosecond, kilosecond, megasecond, and gigasecond.
No. Wait.
Gigasecond.
But if those are just a certain number of seconds, then it's still based in second, right?
I think they might be like smaller versions of a second.
Like if a gigasecond is just X number of seconds, that doesn't feel like a different measurement of time. That's just a different word for the same thing. Like I want something that doesn't even acknowledge how long a second is. If that makes sense.
Well, I think a second is the universal name for a measurement of time. So like a millisecond is a microsecond.
But that's why I want a unit of measurement that a second isn't the core measurement of time. In the same way that a centimeter and an inch don't have anything to do with each other. A mile and a kilometer don't have anything to do with each other. I'm going to take this all the way up to the highest people in power.
Why do they call them buffalo wings?
Got to be made in Buffalo, New York, right? Has to be it. I assume.
Because I don't understand that, because I'm a dumb British man. Because I'm like, buffaloes don't have wings.
No, I believe they were created in Buffalo, New York, which is a relatively largest city in New York. It's a big sports team, the Buffalo Bills. I imagine wings were created there. Probably first dude to put some sloppy sauce on them and slop it all up.
And so is it the buffalo sauce as well? Is that like a type of sauce?
Yeah, it's just a little chicken wing. And a buffalo sauce is kind of like a slightly like a vinegary red's hot sauce, a little creamy.
Okay. Go Team Venture says Buffalo, New York at the Anchor Bar, apparently.
There you go. Look at that. Hell yeah. You're playing a trip to Buffalo. You like buffalo wings?
I've only had buffalo wings once, and that was when I was in America while watching the Super Bowl. So it's very connected with that with me.
In Boston.
And they were nice.
Right, in Boston?
Yeah, in Boston. I was watching. Yeah, and then I went to the Winners Parade.
You went to the Winners Parade.
Yeah.
Who could ever forget that?
Never.
So buffalo wings aren't like not a big thing in England?
Not as far as I'm aware. Like, you can't really buy them in stores and stuff.
Yeah.
And before Lampy comes in and says, actually, Jay, you can buy them in this one specific shop.
You live out in the country.
Yeah, I don't leave my house.
Not since the incident.
Nope, not since the Vancouver incident. Sometimes when I can't sleep, I listen to videos to go to bed. Like, I put something on, I close my eyes, I just listen to it.
Yeah.
And for some reason, YouTube has started auto-playing, like, SCP horror stories.
Oh, that's a terrifying thing to listen to.
Yeah, and, like, I wake up in the middle of the night, and it's just this softly spoken man saying, like, yes. And then the SCP-159 just consumed all the flesh of the children, and they were left as husks. And I'm like, I want to not be in here right now.
Can I not listen to this at this point?
Yeah, it's like, how is this on? Like,
yeah, I don't want to be on. I listen to podcasts at night.
Yeah,
I just kind of have them on in the background, and for some reason it has, and I think it's because I was checking something. A friend of mine listened to Breakout from a while ago and sent me a weird timestamp where there's a weird voice at one point. And it was an episode that Nick wasn't on. It was me, Casey, and Jesse. And at one point, there's like a weird like voice you can hear in the background. And I'm assuming it's something that was in one of our computers was playing, right?
Yeah.
But it is very, it's pretty spooky. And so I listened to that and I was like, oh, it's kind of spooky. Because none of us heard it when we were live on the show.
Yeah.
However, ever since he sent me that link and I listened to that 5 seconds on Spotify, in the middle of the night when I'm listening to my podcast, it'll occasionally just go, it'll just start playing an episode of Breakout. And the second I hear my own voice, I wake up. And it's so annoying. And Spotify, like, usually it would just randomly play another episode of whatever podcast I was listening to, but every once in a while I'll just play an episode of Breakout. I'm like, I don't want this Spotify. I don't want to listen to my own voice.
Yeah, stop doing this. Yeah, it's fucked. Like, are you someone who like doesn't like the sound of your own voice?
Oh no, I don't mind the sound of my own voice. I just wake up every time I hear it. I don't want to wake up anymore.
Your brain just automatically wakes up. Yeah, like some horror story.
I think it's because it's worried that my doppelganger's there.
I get it sometimes. Like, sometimes I'll so like when a new video comes out of mine on the Escapist, I'll as a lot of people who comment on my videos will know, like I'll respond to all the comments for the first like day or two. So I like keep the video open and, you know, and then go about my business and then come back and comment on the video. But sometimes I accidentally leave the video on and like go off and do something and come back and continue working.
Yeah.
And it's also playing the rest of my videos.
Yeah.
And I can just very subtly hear myself talking.
Yeah.
And it freaks me out. I'm like, where is that coming from?
Like, is this what just is happening? Like my inner voice? Yeah.
Is this how I die? Like,
is this how I die?
But no, it's just a video playing on another tab.
No one's dead. It's fine.
It's fine.
No, it's great.
The Vancouver incident was a long time ago. It's fine.
We got just a few minutes left in the stream. While we start wrapping up, Jay, what do you got going on? What should folks be checking out? What's new? What's new in the J zone?
There's quite a bunch new in the J zone, actually. I'll keep this brief because a lot of you have already heard this towards the beginning. But for anyone who enjoys my show Anatomy, it is no longer. It is dead. We have killed it.
Oh no.
But not in a bad way. So
killed it in a good way.
Killed in a very pleasant way. We have decided to rebrand Anatomy for a whole host of reasons that I won't get into right now, but for positive reasons. So the show is being rebranded to Design Delve, and the crux of it is just to allow me to focus on allow me to do broader topics. So to focus the videos on specific topics in game design rather than just focusing on one game, because the name forced me to do one game, the Anatomy of X. So we now have a new series, which is ostensibly just Anatomy, but just a little bit more broad. But we got new visuals, we got new logos, we got new, there's a little bit more of a different feel. And I'd like to ask you guys for your opinions. Everyone who likes my show to go and watch it. I have removed the little green screen skits for this first episode just to see how it feels, to see if it makes it flow a little bit better, to see. And I'd really like to hear your guys' opinions of whether you want those little green screen bits back or you think it's better without, stuff like that. So please comment on that video and let me know, because I'd really like your feedback on that. But yeah, I have that new video, which is on why most Souls-likes fail, which is out for early access members today and will be out officially next Friday. And also, what do I have on? I'm on a stream tomorrow with the wonderful Frost.
Oh, nice.
I can't remember the exact name of the game we're playing.
It's Wishless something. I thought I saw art come through.
Superfuse. So we're going to be playing Superfuse together. It's going to be mine and Frost's first wishlist stream together, which is going to be nice. I'm sure it's going to be some goofs, some spoofs. It's going to be good. But yeah, that's me. That's what I've got on. And then assorted streams throughout the holiday season. I will still be about. I'll still be on some streams.
Yeah.
So look out for those in the future.
Yeah, we don't know our, we've said this in the last couple of streams, we're going to be, obviously, not going to be doing full-time streams, you know, for the next 2 weeks, you know, from pre-Christmas to New Year's. We're going to, you know, hopefully be taking some time off, spend some time with our families. However, we're still going to have occasional streams. We're trying to figure out what that exact schedule is going to look like. So, because we mostly want it to be like, if folks are around and want to stream, then we can stream. And maybe it'll be pairings of people that we don't normally have, you know. Maybe it'll be more of just like a stream like this, where it's like someone playing a game they like and the other person hanging out and hanging out with chat. So, yeah, we'll hopefully have that figured out by Monday. But yeah, before then, obviously tomorrow's wish list. Tomorrow evening will be game night. We're still figuring out what we're going to play. It's either going to be Grounded or like Mario Kart or Mario Party. We haven't figured it out. We have art for everything though, which is very exciting. Sunday will be newly released with Amy playing. I don't know what. Maybe High on Life. I don't know.
Can I ask that if it is Mario Kart, you let me know because
will you stay up late?
Play Mario Kart.
Okay, you'll stay up late for Kart. Okay.
I'll stay up late for Kart. I won't stay up late for
Grounded.
Grounded.
Like, damn, Xbox taking shots again. No, I fully understand. I'm gonna be honest. I don't want to play Mario Kart 2. We'll see. We'll just make an executive decision.
Yeah. If not, we'll get to it another time. It's just if it is.
Yeah.
Let me know.
Yeah, and then we'll be having normal streams the first half of the week. Like we'll definitely be doing slightly something else and recap and breakout and everything, and then. Casey and I finished Metal Gear Solid 4 last night. You guys should check that out. So we're nearing the end of our Metal Gear journey. We just have the Revengeance aperitif left. Our little digestif. Ooh. No, digestif. That's what you have at the end. And then we're figuring out what our streaming series, our next one's going to be. We think we want to do Half-Life. Casey's never played Half-Life.
Keen.
We can give him a whole life. So we're going to figure that out. And then, check out everything on the website. We got a lot of great written features we're really bolstering up, so check that out. And, you can follow us both on our Twitch channels. I'm sure we'll both probably be doing some personal streams as well throughout the next 2 weeks. I'll be doing one later tonight, probably around 6 p.m. Central, so check out that. And, thank you guys so much for joining and for helping get through. This was the first game stream I hosted on The Escapist, which I think I went off without a hitch.
Honestly, flawlessly. Even more flawless than like any of our usual ones, because usually there's something that goes wrong. Nothing went wrong.
All it took was like 90 minutes of me worrying beforehand. And
apparently that's it. So just, if you show up thinking everything's going to be fine.
All it took was me getting an ulcer this morning, and it was fine. So thank you all so much for joining us. Jermaine, thank you so much, obviously, for being my co-pilot in this. As a reminder, if you weren't here earlier, there will be no Halo stream tonight or later this afternoon because of Nick's dog incident plus the fence incident plus...
he's still stuck on the fence, yeah.
Still stuck on the fence, yeah. Oh my God, Lampy says my camera's been reversed this whole time. Well, it doesn't. There's no text. If I'm reversed, it's fine. I'm so confused. I'm in the same direction I always am. Fucking Lampy. This is when Lampy is a scampy. Thank you all so much. I hope you all have a wonderful rest of your day, and we'll see you all on streams tonight, tomorrow, Sunday, your dreams in the middle of the night in your basements. Who knows?
Watch out.
Bye, everyone. Have a wonderful
day.
I'm going to see if we have a transition screen.
Oh, let's see.